Jindal of you. Today I am here to continue further with exercise 13.1. As I have discussed earlier that your first exercise is based on the concept of direct proportion. So here whatever question you are going to deal with, those all questions will be direct proportion. So I will show you the formula that what we are going to apply. So in this exercise we will apply the formula of x1 y2 equals to x2 y1. So always remember, when you are going to apply the concept of direct proportion, you will apply x1 into y2 equals to x2 into y1. What we need to do, first of all, on the basis of given information, we will try to draw a figure, we will try to draw a table, and then in the first quantity, we will represent the quantities related to the x, and in the second row, that will represent the quantities related to y, and then we will decide which of the quantities is missing, and then accordingly we are going to find it. So here are some questions on the basis of your syllabus. Then in the classwork we are going to solve 1, 4, 6, 8 and 10, and in your homework part the remaining, that is 2, 3, 5, 7 and 9, those will be homework. Although those questions are given in homework, but if in case you are feeling problem in understanding the question, do ask the teacher. So here I am going to start with the first question. If you have the book or you can see from the NCERT, it says that following are the car parking charges near a railway station, and the charges are given as follows. For the 4 hours it is 60 rupees, for 8 hours it is 100, for 12 hours it is 140, and for 24 hours it is 180. I need to check that whether the given quantities are in direct proportion or not. If you remember, for the direct proportion, the ratio of the quantities must be coming a constant value. That is, x by y should come as constant value. Now here, the hours and the parking charges are two different quantities. So first we take the ratio of the same, that whether they are coming in constant value or not. As for the 4 hours, the charges will be 60. If you simplify, that becomes 1 by 15. That is the first charge. Second charge is given as for 8 hours, and that is given as 100 rupees. So when you simplify, that becomes 2 by 25. Third parking charge, that is for 12 hours, it is given as for 140. So when you reduce it by 4, that becomes 3 by 35. And the fourth charge is given for 24 hours, and that is rupees 118. And you reduce it by 12, that becomes 2 by 15. So these are the charges. So when I have formulated the ratio of the same, first is coming out as 1 by 15, second 2 by 25, third 3 by 35, fourth 2 by 15. Any of the ratios are not coming equal. So it means that they are not in direct proportion according to the concept. So as 4 by 60 is not equals to 8 by 100 is not equals to 12 by 140 is not equals to 24 by 180. As if you remember, it was saying that x1 by y1 equals to x2 by y2 equals to x3 by y3 all should be coming in equal. But here, they are not coming in equal. As the following charges are not in equal, therefore, Parking charges are not in direct proportion. Therefore, the parking charges are not in direct proportion. Suppose agar ye iski jagah if you have given in the form of table, where you need to check that whether they are in inverse proportion or not. So in that case, we would have multiplied the first and second, because in inverse proportion, x into y, that should come as constant. So accordingly, the concept which has been discussed, for checking that whether the given quantity are in direct, you have to take the ratio of those two quantities. So if the ratio is not coming constant value, then it will conclude that they are not in direct proportion. Fine? So this is question number 1. This was to check that whether their parking charges are in direct proportion or not. number 4. I'll let you know how to the proper procedure of solving. And the next is given as a machine in a software factory fills 840 bottles in 6 hours. It is given as number of bottles. And the second is given as time duration. If you take the number of bottles to be represented as quantity X and time duration and quantity Y, number of bottles are 840, taking 6 hours to complete that. In 5 hours, how much bottles will be made, how much bottles will be filled, that we need to find it out. So X1 quantity, that will become X1, and this will become X2. Similarly, this will become Y1, and this will become Y2. I'm telling you the procedure that how you will identify where is X1, Y1, where is X2, Y2. So if this quantity you have taken as X, this digital values will come in this row, that will become X1, X2, X3, X4, and so on. If this quantity you have taken as Y, so this become Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, and so on. It is not mandatory that you can take first as X, second as Y. By possible you can take first as Y, second as X. So that could be possible. तो अगर आपने इसको y लिया है तो दैट इज y1 y2 y3 y4 एंड सो ऑन इसको x लिया है x1 x2 x3 x4 एंड सो ऑन तो दैट इज डिसाइडेड बाय यू ओनली दैट व्हाट यू हैव टेकन x और y फॉर दिस रो फाइन सो फर्स्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन फर्स्ट ड्रॉ द टेबल नाउ इट इज क्लियरली विजिबल दैट इफ द टाइम रिड्यूसेस द नंबर ऑफ बॉटल्स टू बी फिल्ड विल डिक्रीज सो आई एम टेकिंग लेट the number of bottles filled the what alpha will be taken that will be taken as terminals fine as since it is in direct proportion therefore, formula for that x1, y2, x2, y1. So x1, y2, that become 840 into 5 equals to x. X and multiple signs will be same, so let it be taken as this. X into 5. So value of x, sorry, 840 into 5, x into 6. As y1 is 6, so this becomes 840 into 5 by 6, cancel 140 times, so this becomes value of x is 700 bottles. So in 5 hours, the number of bottles will be 700 bottles. I hope it is clear. The first of you is inside the table. Then if you have taken first as x quantity, so whatever values will come here, that will become x1, x2, x3, x4 and so on. Second is taken as y, so whatever value comes here, that is y1, y2, y3, y4 and so on. At a time, you will take any two quantity to get any missing value and applying the concept of x1 into y2 equals to x2 into y1. I hope this is clear. So now, we will proceed with question number 6, which is related with the modelship and actualship. As in question number 6, says that in a modelship, the mast, what do you mean mast? Mast is that cloth which leads the boat to flow in a certain direction. That is the mast. So there are two quantities. First I am taking modelship. Then I am taking actual ship. And two things which are being compared, one is mast and the other is length. Mast of model ship is given as 9 cm high, but in actual it is 12 meter. If the length of ship is actual, ship is 28 meter, what will be the length of model ship? If the length of actual ship is increased, then it's quite possible the length compared to mast. So we will take, let the length of modern ship be x, since it is in direct proportion. Therefore, now this is x1, this is y2, but the units are not same, make sure that you cannot cancel 9 with 28 or 9 with 12 when the kind of calculation will come. So make sure that you calculate the same unit, 9 cm into 28 meter, 12 meter into x. So what will the value of x become? 9 cm into 28 meter divided by 12 meter. So meter will cancel the meter part. 4 threes are 4 sevens are 3 ones are 3 threes are. So 3 sevens are become 21 centimeters. So length of model ship is 21 centimeters. Yeah, this way you are going to get the answer. You only have to make the table and then you will easily understand what needs to be done. Why am I telling you this procedure? Because as you will go with higher classes, the same concept if you are studying in your junior classes, the concept will be same, but the process of solving become different. And if you won't learn the new process, you won't understand it. So that's why I'm applying this concept. So this is question number 6. Now we'll go for question number 8. Question number 8 says that Rashmi has a roadmap with a scale of 1 cm representing 18 km. So two things are there, distance on map and actual distance. If the distance on map is 1 cm, actual it is 18 km. Now what would be the distance covered by the map if she covers on road 72 km? Now distance on map, how much it will be represented? So again we start, let the distance on map be x, since it is in, as actual distance from 18 to 72 it has been increased, so distance on map should also increase. As increase in one leads to increase in other, so as it is in direct proportion, therefore x1 into y2, 72 km, as centimeter cannot cancel the kilometer. So, but I am writing them together. If I need to change, I will surely change it. And same way, 18 km into x. So, value of x become 1 centimeter into 72 km by 18 km. Kilometer will cancel kilometer. 18 will cancel 72 4 times. 4 into 1 become 4 centimeter. So distance on map will be 4 cm. Actual distance will be 72, then the distance on map is 4 km. Clear? So this is question number 8. It's quite simple. You only have to make the table and then you can decide what is missing, apply the formula and get the answer. So this is question number 8. And then I'll go for question number 10. This says that a loaded truck travels 14 km in 25 minutes. Distance is given and time is given. 14 km in 25 minutes in 5 hours. How much distance will be covered if the speed remains the same? So let distance traveled is x kilometer. As now here time increases, so it is quite obvious that distance increases also, because the speed remains same, so distance will also increase. So since it is in direct proportion, therefore x1 14 km into 5 hours equals to 25 minutes into x. As here kilometer and hour is there, but here minute is there. So what I do, I will convert hour in minute. As 1 hour is 60 minutes, so 5 hour become 300 minutes. So 14 into 300 by 25, as now units become same. So 25 will cancel 300 12 times, and 14 into 12 become 168 kilometer. So the area of the x is 168 km, is the distance covered by the loaded truck in 5 hours. So these are all the 5 questions according to the syllabus. So whatever the rest 5 are there, and just try to solve. If you have finished problem, do ask it. If you are able to solve, it means you have understood the concept, and all the rest for the same. This is all about today's class. In next class, I will continue with exercise 13.2, which is totally based on the concept of inverse proportion. So there we are going to deal with the question based on inverse proportion. So this is all about today's. Thank you and Jai Hind.